What will be the ultimate fate of our beautiful blue planet? As far as we know, it took 13.8 billion years for our planet to become what it is right now. But like all good things, nothing lasts forever. There are many disastrous calamities waiting right around the corner. How many can the Earth survive? No, we are not talking about global warming or nuclear wars. Those would only destroy humanity. The planet's not going anywhere. Two billion years into the future, the sun will start emitting increased amount of energy so that all of Earth's ocean would evaporate. Of course, the planet would still survive, dry and roasted. Now, as we know, the Andromeda Galaxy is the closest big galaxy to our own Milky Way, and currently about 2.5 million light years apart. Both are fueled by gravity on their way to collisions at a speed of about 402,000 km per hour. But even at the speed, the crash will take another 4 billion years to happen, and that will cause the end of Milky Way as we know it. This is how it will look from Earth 3.75 billion years from now. Before the two galaxies collide, scrambling stars and reconstructing constellations, until eventually, after a billion years of a stellar collision, the cores of the two galaxies merge to form a new one. The good news is that our personal sun or solar system is going to outlive our galaxy. It will just have a new address, Milkdromeda, a single large red and dead gas-free elliptical galaxy. In another 5 to 6 billion years, the sun would have almost exhausted the hydrogen in its core, at which point the helium fusion will begin. As the sun becomes a true red giant, it will swell so much that it would have already eaten Mercury and Venus. The Earth may just survive by approximately 10 to 20 million miles. Eventually running out of fuel after 9.5 billion years, the red giant will also die. And when a lower mass star like the sun runs out of fuel, it blows off its outer layer in a planetary nebulae, but the center contracts down to form a white dwarf. What about the Earth? The Earth would continue to orbit the corpse of what was once our sun. After 10 raises to the power 15 years, the white dwarf would have radiated even the last amount of its energy to become a black dwarf. So the sun has cooled down completely, but the Earth still remains almost undisturbed, comparatively of course. Now, as you might know, a large amount of gravitational interaction between the star system do occur. And when that happens, a star can receive a large enough kick to be ejected from a usual address. We have observed runaway stars from the Milky Way even today. And once they go, they never return. This is estimated to happen to our sun as well, around 10 to the power 19 years from now. What will happen to Earth at that point of time? Well, even if it happens, even if the sun is ejected out of our solar system, it will most probably take as much of the solar system with it, as much as its gravitational force would allow. The Earth and the moon will remain bound to the sun even if it occurs. Now, random merger, collisions, gravitational ejections, all of them are possible, but not very likely. Instead, Earth's eventual death would occur as a result of its orbit being decayed because of gravitational waves. The eventual gravitational radiation would cause the Earth to spiral in and be swallowed by the black dwarf remains of what was once our sun. This is the ultimate fate of our planet. But what is the ultimate fate of humanity? Will we vanish around just 2 billion years into the future, while the planets are getting roasted? Or would we have become an interstellar civilization by then? What do you think? Give your answers in the comment section below.